You are the Judiciary Committee Chair.
Yes.
And you led proceedings for the newest Court of Appeals Chief Judge, Janet DiFiore.
Yes.
So let's take a look at that right now.
Okay. All right. 10 years as an assistant DA, Westchester County. Westchester County Judge, 4 years. Supreme Court Judge, 3 years. As a supervising judge of the criminal courts for the 9th Judicial District. And serving from 2006, the DA of Westchester County, till the present time. She has served on gubernatorial commissions as chair of the Joint Commission on Public Ethics and the Commission on Juvenile Justice. In the past, chief judges of the Court of Appeals can be split into two categories. Consensus builders, acting as a whip to get the bench to think as one mind or opinions, or allow splits in the court's reasoning and many different opinions in the majority of cases. What will be your style as a chief judge?
Well, I believe that it's important for a court, the Court of Appeals of our state, the highest court, to speak with one authoritative voice when that is possible and to produce a strong authoritative decisional body of law. And I think that unanimity or near unanimity is worth the effort to attempt to achieve. But on occasion, there will be foundational disagreements in cases in which you can't use reach unanimity.
And joining Mrs. DiFiore today is her husband, Dennis, her sons, Joseph and Michael, and her daughter, Alexandra Murphy. And we welcome them all today. And I would be remiss if I didn't mention the nominee's love of her life, her granddaughter, Charlotte Murphy.
A very beautiful family. One of my biggest concerns, and many of the members of the judiciary, when we were questioning Janet DiFiore, was her independence. Will she be independent from the governor? Because, as you know, she chaired J-COPE, a commission that he appointed her, also with the juvenile justice. She was a task force member. And I wanted to make sure if ever we had constitutional issues between the governor and the legislature, where the governor wants to bypass the legislature
in excess. Happening.
Yeah, like we see happening in Washington, where the governor wants to exercise his executive authority. I want to make sure that she and the rest of the court can look at the constitutional issues separately, and she doesn't feel that there's an IOU owed to Governor Cuomo for making her the chief justice. I think she handles herself very well. The state bar approved her, qualified, trial lawyers, very qualified. The district attorneys, liked her. So I think we have a good one here. I think Governor Cuomo had a good pick, a very impressive nominee, and we wish her well